team mobbing. When I come around, got the whole thing wobbing. When I come around, got the whole thing wobbing.
Hey there, everybody. How's it going? Welcome back to another episode of Power Rangers Weekly here on my channel. Now, I got a pretty cool video for you guys here today. I want to do a quick review on the Lightning Collection Mighty Morphin figures from Hasbro. Now that Hasbro is producing the Power Rangers toy line and not Bandai. But before we get into the video, if you guys are new to this channel and you're a Power Rangers fan, if you're just a fan of pop culture in general, be sure to click that subscribe button and click the little bell icon so that you guys can be notified of everything that goes on this channel. And let's get started.
It's Morphin time.
Alright guys, let's go ahead and get into this video. Now you'll see here that I have the red Mighty Morphin figure and the pink Mighty Morphin figure, both from Hasbro. This is a part of the new Lightning Collection series. Now, I actually hadn't planned on doing this video until I had gotten my yellow Mighty Morphin figure. I had pre-ordered it from GameStop. I was supposed to have it already, but due to the COVID-19 pandemic, I don't have it now. So I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna go ahead and review the ones that I have, give my thoughts and opinions on it, and let you know whether or not I like them. I started out only buying the Red Ranger, and I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna go ahead and get the entire Mighty Morphin set, and then I'll probably just call it good right there. But my overall thoughts and opinions on these figures from Hasbro is meh. For about $20 to $22, you're getting what you're paying for. They're not terrible figures, they're just not the greatest. There's a lot of people out there that would debate on this that are saying, you know, these are like the greatest things since canned bread. But my personal opinion, I would prefer the Bandai figures well over these. The Bandai figures had better quality, they were just better made. One of the things that you'll notice when we go up close and personal with these is the faces. Now, the big thing about the Lightning Collection figures is that they come with interchangeable heads. So you get like the helmets, like normal, and you also get their faces, like their actual faces. The whole thing is if you're gonna sell these figures with their faces, where you can interchange the helmets from the faces, is at least take the time to make them look like the characters from the shows. The red and the pink ranger here, the faces that they have for these figures, they actually look okay. Like, if you look at the Mighty Morphin Black Ranger figure, Zach's face looks terrible. Like, I don't know what they sculpted that from, but it looks nothing like Walter Jones, and it makes me so mad that people love that figure. I mean, the figure is cool and all, but the face just looks god-awful. Same with the Blue Zeo Ranger figure that's coming out. It looks nothing like Rocky at all. Like, I even follow Steve Cardenas on Instagram, and he posted a shot of that, and he's like, this looks nothing like me. And I'm like, no, sir, it doesn't. It looks terrible. And of course, the Green Ranger, White Ranger, and Lord Jacken figure that all have Tommy's face sculpt look exactly like JDF, because JDF is the greatest thing ever to happen to Power Rangers. But aside from the face sculpts not being 100% accurate, I do like these. Like I said, they're just kind of meh to me. But overall, they are pretty nice. They are a lot shorter than the Bandai figures. So let's go ahead and get more up close and personal with these figures and have a closer look at them.
All right, so here's an up close shot of the figure itself. And you see the detail is actually pretty good. One of the things that I do like is that it does come with the weapons as well. Like the Bandai collection, the Legacy collection, they made the figures like normal, but then they had like the metallic set that you could buy that actually had their weapons. So if you wanted the Rangers with their weapons, you could buy two different sets. Plus, sorry there, I kind of stuttered a little bit. So I didn't like that, but me loving Power Rangers as much as I do, I ended up buying both sets so that I could have both the metallic and the non-metallic figures as well. And actually, see guys what I mean right here? Like, that kind of looks like Austin St. John's face, but yet again, it doesn't. And this by far is not the worst one. If you look at some of the others, like I said, like the Black Rangers, it just looks terrible. I don't like it. Flip it over here on the back. On the back of the box, it's really nothing special. You just get another picture of the Ranger itself with his weapons in his hands. That's literally all you get on the back of the box. Nothing special. Moving on here to the Pink Ranger. It's pretty much the same thing as the Red Ranger. She comes with her weapons as well. And right here, if you look, this looks really nothing like Amy Jo Johnson's face at all. Like, I don't know what they were thinking when they did that. I feel like they just had a bunch of pictures of women on their idea board, and they threw a dart at it, and whichever one it hit, they're like, okay, let's just go with that one. It's good enough. So I'm not a fan of this one at all. Like, it's not the worst one, though. Like I've said, there's some other ones that are pretty bad as well, but this one just isn't the greatest. And same thing again on the back. It's just a picture of the figure again. Nothing special at all. Just a picture of the figure.
Yeah guys, that's my take on the Lightning Collection figures from Hasbro. Like I said, I was wanting to do this when I had the Yellow Ranger figure, here as well, but things happen. So what are your guys' thoughts and opinions on the Lightning Question figures? Do you have any of them? What is your favorite figure that they have produced so far? Let me know down in the comments below. I'd love to know what you guys think of these. I want to know which ones you have, which ones you don't have, and which ones you are excited to get. I'm personally excited to get the entire Mighty Morphin set, and I want to get the Black Ranger without the Dragon Shield. They have that one out now, but I don't like the Dragon Shield on the Black Ranger. I just prefer it to not be there. So I'm going to wait to get that and hopefully complete my Mighty Morphin collection and then stop right there. I don't plan on getting any more of the Lightning collections after Mighty Morphin. I might get Zeo. I don't know yet. So yeah, guys, be sure to drop a like on this video. Be sure to comment and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.